Hell yes, we're going to take your AR-15, your AK-47. We're not going to allow it to be used against our fellow Americans anymore.
We bring social workers into homes of parents to help them deal with how to raise their children. It's not that they don't want to help. They don't know quite what to do. Play the radio. Make sure the television, make sure you have the record player on at night, the phone. Make sure the kids hear words. A kid coming from a very poor school, or a very poor background, will hear 4 million words fewer spoken by the time they get there.
You really have to elect me. Whether you like me or not, it makes no difference, because our country will go to hell. If any of these people get in, it'll go to hell.
And that is Congressman Beto O'Rourke, former Vice President Joe Biden, and President Trump last night in Baltimore, the two Democrats from their debate in Houston. You heard it all on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5. I'm Robert Lang, alongside Eurypsy Morgan today, who was in for C4. Eurypsy, last night I was in the studio as all this was going down, and you wear a set of headphones like this every day when you're on the air. So as the president was speaking, I had the president in my left ear. I had the Democrats in my right ear because the president's speech was during the first hour of the debate. Had to bring the listeners up to date on what was going on with the debate before we joined it in progress. And I suppose in my brain, I wanted to get the two sounds mixed and form the perfect candidate. I don't think we got that, but let's talk about last night in terms of the president was, I think this was deliberate on the president's part to delay the speech and the House Republicans' part to delay the speech until the debate so you could see the contrasts.
Well, first, I hope you took a Motrin after
that.
Oh,
I did. And then I slept like a baby just to clear my brain.
That sounded exhausting. But, you know, it probably was deliberate. Although I don't know how much of that took away from the debate, because the reality is, you know, I know the Democrats are still so many that it's hard to focus. I think for a lot of people, we're still kind of, other than us who are entrenched in this political, stuff, I think for a lot of Americans, they're still kind of waiting to wade through the last remaining candidates.
So people really won't start. I mean, it's now longer the summer. People are back to school. You start thinking about serious stuff like this. But people, I guess, won't be really deciding who to support in the presidential race until maybe next year, early next year, you know, as you see how the caucuses and the primaries take place.
Yes, although I will say that this debate did highlight, I think for me it was one of the times when they are starting to kind of break out, like you just heard Representative Beto O'Rourke. I don't know that anybody was ready to go where he did, getting, we're going to take the AR-15s, and nor has that been something that Democrats have been willing to, I think, say out in the open.
But President Trump and the Republicans want Democrats like Beto O'Rourke or Elizabeth Warren proposing what some people would consider to be wild, radical ideas, because the president will say, as he said last night, we'll go straight to hell if any of these people are elected.
Well, and that's the thing is they kind of teed it up for him. I mean, that has been the president's strategy when he's attacked the squad, AOC and them, making them the face of the Democratic Party, even though, you know, I've spoken to a lot of Democrats who say, I'm a Democrat, but not that kind of Democrat. But when you put them at the forefront, when you make them the face, it makes it very easy to make that the argument that, hey, elect a Democrat and this is what you're going to get. And Beto O'Rourke yesterday just teed it up for him.
All right. That is Eurypsy Morgan, who has been, I've interrupted her show a lot this week. So I want to thank you very much for that. We have had a lot of breaking news during the Eurypsy Morgan show. And she is back Monday 1 to 3 on WBAL. And C4 is back 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.